holidays. My name is Lonnie Johnson. I want to talk to you guys about how I just spent the last month and a half in Hawaii and how it was the best month and a half of my life. First things first, when you think of Hawaii, what really pops into your head? Because I know before I went and what I experienced, it was a lot different. Like, it's totally different. When I first think of Hawaii, I always thought of, you know, just, you know, like people in hula skirts and, you know, people blowing fire and just like an all-out vacation, all-out party. You know, that's how I pictured it, right? But actually going there, I went to the Big Island, I should mention. But actually going there and actually being there for quite some time, like a month and a half, you actually get to experience you get to experience the party side of it, but you also get to experience the subtle side of it, the calm side of it, you know, when it's Tuesday and everyone is at work, stuff like that. You actually get to live like a local. So Hawaii is truly amazing. And it's something that I didn't know what I was going to get when I went there. I knew it would be fun, but I didn't know, you know, how fun. I'll say that. If you guys are planning to go on a trip there, hopefully I'll talk about a few of the best scenic points that you guys can go to. There's so much that I didn't get to do, and I will go back to do more. The difference between the Big Island and the other islands on the island chain is the Big Island has more, it's better to find more waterfalls, right? More, you know, like local swim spots. It's more scenic, beautiful, you know? And there's so much to do. You literally, you know, all of the islands can fit inside of the Big Island. So you literally could, you know, you have an abundance of things that you can do when you're on the Big Island. When you're on the other islands, they are great, like Maui and stuff like that. But they're like mini, it's like a mini LA, you know, it's like you kind of know what to expect there. Still beautiful. Now, you know, don't get me wrong, it's still beautiful, but the Big Island, it gives you that, you get the more cultural feel when you're on the Big Island. So if that is something that you're looking for, that cultural feel, and you just want to kind of see how they live and kind of embrace it and, you know, just experience it, definitely go to the Big Island. There's so many beautiful places, so many beautiful waterfalls, beaches, like surf beaches. It's totally amazing. Discuss with you guys before I go into how great Hawaii is, I'm gonna give you guys three things that kind of, you know, offset it just a little bit. Not nothing too negative, but something that was kind of, you will notice, trust me. The first thing is the humidity with how hot it is. All of my clothes mildewed, like every single shoes, socks, boxers, underwear, and shirts, jackets, everything mildewed. So I had to wash everything and let it air dry, you know, and get it used to those conditions, because everything mildewed. That was probably a little setback, but not too much. I just went to actually the Airbnb I was staying at, they had a washer and dryer, so it's pretty cool. Another thing is, and this is something that you guys do want to note, it is very expensive in Hawaii. When I say expensive, it's not what you're used to on the mainland. You know, so you want to plan ahead that, okay, milk maybe will cost you $8. You know what I'm saying? So you want to plan ahead for things like that. Groceries will be a lot more. As far as Airbnbs and stuff like that, you know, you can find your budget, but necessities that you have to get when you're over there, they will cost more. So it's just something to keep in mind. Other than that, I don't really think there was anything else that I did not like. And it's not that I didn't like those things. I thought that those things were very unique. It's what kind of makes Hawaii, Hawaii. And it's so beautiful. So, you know, it's kind of like you get the bang for your buck. Now, what I did like about Hawaii, I don't even know where to start, honestly. First, I'm going to go with just like, it's so slow, right? They call it, everything is moving slow. They call it Hawaii time. It's pretty much like people do things on their own time because the days are longer. And I'm not joking. Literally, it seemed like I would be up for 2 days. I would get so much done because it just seems like I'm working for 2 days or I'm working for an entire day. And I was able to get a lot accomplished. So it felt like I was waking up. It felt like I was actually sleeping in to like 12 to like noon, you know. But I was waking up at 7, being super productive, getting so much work done. And I was going to sleep. As well at around 10 o'clock, no later than 11, you know, so that time change, it was so weird, so crazy, but so cool. People are super nice there. It's so beautiful. Like, this is a top thing. It's so beautiful. Everywhere you turn, it's like a waterfall. Everywhere you turn, there's a swimming hole where you could swim, like a local hidden gym. Everywhere you turn, and Texas is so big. That Hawaii, the big island, it takes like 2 hours, 2.5 hours to get to the other side of the island. That's like a trip to the airport from where I'm staying. So I'm used to making those trips. So it was super, 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 super easy and useful for me, convenient actually, to just, you know, go to the next trip or plan something else and then make that happen. I was gone for like a month and a half. I did enjoy myself. I did make some good connections, and you know, these are memories that I will never forget. And honestly, man, if you're thinking about going to Hawaii, just go. You know, if you got the money, go ahead and book it. If you're waiting on people, 9 times out of 10, they're not gonna be ready when you're ready. So just go ahead and book it and go. You'll have a wonderful time. It's a good nightlife. It's perfect. I did get an opportunity to stay there full time, and I did get an opportunity to stay there full time, but I am working on continuously traveling, so who knows where my next travel adventure will be. Well, I know, I kind of have a clue, but so I didn't want to, you know, commit to any one thing. So if you guys are honestly thinking about going to Hawaii, you should check it out. You should try it. If you're waiting on other people to go with you, just go. They're not going to be ready when you are ready. So just book the trip, honestly.
3, 2, 1, go!
Cheer!
You lost the lay. You lost your lay.